essentially in this, what we did was that the way we find out, we figure out what is true, what is not, we use various techniques. So one of them is called Google Reverse Image Search. If you, you know, we do these trainings all over India. If there's an opportunity, we'll come and train here as well. But what if you go to images.google.com on your desktop, you will see a small camera icon there. And you can upload an image there and figure out where the image originally came from. Okay, you go to images.google.com, in the search box on the right, you'll see a small camera icon. You click that camera icon and you upload an image. And it'll give you a set of results as to where all that image has been posted. And using that, you can figure out whether an image is true or not, you know, what is probably the original version of the image. So that is how we found out that, you know, this was essentially a photoshopped image. This is, how many of you have heard of postcard.news? Postcard? So Postcard is a website which runs out of Karnataka. This is a person who runs it, Mahesh Vikram Hegde. He was also arrested. AltNews did multiple stories on the misinformation put out by Postcard, and he was also arrested for one of the stories. So here he's claiming that a majority of you know, of all the rapes that happen, majority of rapes are by Muslims and a majority of victims are Hindus. That is what he's claiming. And if you look at the number of retweets, you know, some 1,200 retweets here, 16,000 likes. Now, we spoke to the crime, you know, the crime that happens across the country. Just 2 days ago, the National Crime Record Bureau has put out the 2017 statistics. So National Crime Record Bureau is the organization which documents what are the crimes happening, the statistics, what is the crime happening in different states, you know, whether it is crimes of different kinds. And we spoke to the ADG of National Crime Record Bureau, and he said that, and we already knew that, that crime is never categorized according to religion. There's no crime, you'll never get statistics where crime is categorized according to religion. But still there's this person who is making this claim, and the ADG told us that this is an absolutely fictitious claim. There's no truth to it. But this was spread like wildfire. Coming to, so we looked at misinformation during conflicts. We looked at misinformation which is meant to target minorities. This is medical misinformation, okay? Again, I don't think you can see the board, but if you go to YouTube and if you type the name of a drug called Eupatorium perfoliatum, okay? If you type this drug, Eupatorium perfoliatum, in YouTube, you will see that there are tens of videos, people making these videos, and they are claiming that Eupatorium perfoliatum can cure chikungunya, Eupatorium perfoliatum can cure dengue, Eupatorium perfoliatum can cure sore muscles, sore bones. So literally multiple things that this supposed homeopathic drug can cure. Now why, you know, one thing that needs to be understood is why is there so many videos which are claiming, you know, these things. There's also financial motive behind putting out this information. When you put out a video on YouTube, you take a camera and you put out video on YouTube, there's a possibility of making money. You know, people who get tens and thousands of views, you see those YouTube ads in between the videos, the people who are actually creating this content, they are making money. So that is one of the reasons why there's so many, there's such a huge increase in YouTube videos and Facebook videos, because you can make money off those videos. Now, the reason why you see so many of videos, and you see thousands and thousands of results when you go to YouTube, and that is because content creation has been incentivized. There was a time 10 years ago when it was not that easy to have a camera, create content, put it online and make money out of it. But it has become very easy these days. So what people are doing is that they think of a topic which they think is popular. So if it is dengue season, they'll create videos about dengue. If it is Zika virus that is being spread, they'll create videos about Zika virus. If it is Article 370, they'll create videos about Article 370. So essentially what is happening is that there are multiple content, quote unquote, they call themselves content creators, who are creating these multiple videos and making money out of it, and since they are not domain experts, very often they put out material which is either partially misinformation or complete misinformation. So this financial incentivization by social media platforms is also a huge issue as to why there is so much misinformation today. Medical misinformation is just not limited to social media. In fact, a lot of it is coming from the government itself. For example, this is Ministry of Health's account, and it is claiming that depression is a state of low mood that affects a person's thought, behavior. Now, we all get affected by low mood, you know. Every one of us get affected by low mood. That is not depression. Just because we have a low mood doesn't mean we are depressed. But this is the Ministry of Health, Union Ministry of Health account claiming that depression is a state of low mood. And in its graphics, as a cure for depression, it says, go for walks, travel, be creative, eat fruits, sleep for minimum 8 hours, think positive. You know, it gives every single, you know, it suggests every single thing other than go to a doctor. You know, the only thing it doesn't say is go to a doctor. And this is Ministry of Health putting out this information. So essentially, when it comes to medical misinformation, it starts right at the top. There's an entire ministry called the Ayush Ministry, which has suggested multiple drugs which do not have the scientific research backing. And we have, you know, we have dealt with a lot of those drugs on AltNews as well. So we have looked at, you know, different kinds of misinformation. Now, as I was earlier mentioning, you know, misinformation is very much organized. So creation of misinformation has two parts to it. One is creating the misinformation, and the other part is making sure that it reaches the widest section of the population possible. Okay, so now what is the misinformation that is being created? Now on the screen, the picture is that of, there's a website called chaskatimes.com. Many of you may not have heard of this website. It has gone down after AltNews wrote a story about it. But there's a bunch of websites called chaskatimes.com, insispost.com, etc. We wrote this story in 2017. Now, on chaskatimes.com, they have put out a picture of Alia Bhatt, a young Alia Bhatt with Mahesh Bhatt, and claiming, in Hindi it is saying, that cinema jagat ki is mashur abhinetri ne khud kabula ki isne apni virginity kho di thi, wo bhi apni pita ke saath. Claiming that this this actress from Bollywood claimed that she lost her virginity to her father. Now, this is the kind of information that is put out on social media. This chaskatimes.com had one person or group of people running multiple websites. So there was another website which is called insispost.com, which would put out a lot of information about how to increase male virility, a lot of BJP propaganda at the etc. And we essentially went and found out who actually runs this website. So this website insispost.com at one point of time was so popular, again, not many people would have heard of it because it runs in different sort of socioeconomic circles, but it had more traffic than firstpost.com. In 2017, firstpost.com had a global rank of 2018, while insispost had a global rank of 1,477. There's a website called alexa.com where you can go and check which website is, you know, how much traffic which website gets. So insispost had more traffic than firstpost.com. So we went and looked for who runs insispost. That, so we found this LinkedIn profile of this person called Ankit Kumar, and he said he's the founder at insispost Media Enterprises. On his Instagram profile also, he said Ankit Pandey, founder of insispost. Okay, so who is Ankit Pandey? The guy on the right is Ankit Pandey. Okay, this guy is Ankit Pandey. So there are people who, you know, who are associated directly or loosely with different political parties. They are absolutely and fully involved in creating misinformation. And it is not limited to one side. So Ankit Pandey has this office in Noida. It is an L-shaped office which has multiple young people sitting, and their job is to create this kind of misinformation. Okay. a lot of these people are making money out of it. They have certain kind of ads at the bottom of the article where you essentially click and these people will make money. The guy with Rahul Gandhi, his name is Abhishek Mishra, also with Kamal Nath. Now, this is the other side, you know. As I started, you know, the misinformation is not the domain of any specific political party. It may be coming more from one side, but everybody uses that as a weapon. So this guy, Abhishek Mishra, he used to run a website called viralinindia.in, okay? And he would put out posts like this. He would say that Manmohan Singh has been declared as the most powerful prime minister in the world, okay? Now, this is pandering to the other side, you know. There's one sort of misinformation which is pandering to one side. This is misinformation which is pandering to the other side. He would, this violent India would put out posts like Manmohan Singh has been declared as one of the 50 most honest political leaders in the world. So again, this is this is information which political, when you see this, you know, when you see this photo, it is not that these political parties don't know what Abhishek Mishra is doing. They very well know that he runs this website which constantly puts out misinformation. But these people, whether it is Ankit Pandey with Amit Shah or Abhishek Mishra with Rahul Gandhi, these politicians know what impact misinformation can have, and that is why they support for such people.